here. It's really interesting with the millennials because it is truly one of the first generations in the history of our world, not just in the U.S., where it was almost like the boomers raised an entire generation the same across the world, right? I've been asked to speak at international HR conferences in places like Brazil, and all over the place. And what's interesting is that how the millennials are in different countries are identical to the U.S. I've got quotes from VPs of marketing and VPs of engineering from companies based out of China, and the descriptions that they have for their millennials and the challenges that they have for the millennials are identical to what a VP of marketing or engineering or whatever department might be saying here in, you know, San Jose. So it's a very interesting dynamic. And a lot of, obviously, technology has a lot to do with that. I typically speak on the workforce literally walking out of the building. Gen X is a very small generation. There's not enough of them. Millennials are a larger generation. So all of a sudden, you're going to find, and you might even be seeing it now, 22, 23, 24-year-olds with only 2 years of maybe practical workforce experience, let alone maturity issues, all that stuff, right? Getting moved into management roles. So management training, leadership training is huge for them. I'm getting more and more. Wells Fargo, Johnson & Johnson, eBay, all kinds of companies hiring me to come in and do leadership boot camps for the millennials because they've got 23-year-olds running the show with groups of individuals that are ranging from their age up to 65 years old, right? And they don't have a lot of practical experience. One other stat before I move on, the reason this topic is important, one boomer, a new stat. One boomer on average is retiring every 8 seconds. That's a lot of people.